My name is Miguel Fluxa. I come from Mallorca. I work at Camper. I'm a member of the fourth generation of a family business, which is Camper, that my great-grandfather founded 136 years ago. And today we're in New York, where we're opening this store designed by Nendo, and we're doing a little event here at the store. The story started in 1877, when my great-grandfather actually founded the first shoe factory in Spain. He bet on doing good quality shoes, Goodyear welted. He was a farmer, and he probably didn't speak any English, and he went to France and England, and he came back after a couple of years with the machinery to set up this. Then after many years, in 1975, my father joined the family business, and he created the Camper as a brand within the family business, and incorporated basically two things, which is to this heritage of know-how of how to make shoes and the quality, he incorporated design and comfort. And this is the basis of the product today, which is still works. Camper means farmer in Mallorquin, which is the language that we speak in Mallorca. The success probably has been trying to make something different, original, with identity and with quality. And when we started to open stores outside of Spain and in many different places, we thought that it was interesting to not to repeat themselves. I mean, the world today is in a way is becoming a little bit boring, and everything is becoming so equal one to the other. So we thought that it was interesting for the brand and interesting for the cities also to do different designs from one place to the other. Well, we have worked with many people, from Martí Guixé, which is a Spanish designer, to the Borlaug brothers, the Campana brothers, Alfredo Haberly, some Japanese. We have worked with Nendo, of course, with Tokujin Yoshioka, with Shigeru Ban, which is an architect, because we also do some things with architects. I don't know, many different, Konstantin Grzyk. A lot of people, actually, yeah.
Do you sort of study the effects of their design? Do you look at it from a commercial perspective of which stores perform the best? Or for you, is it sort of a cultural thing, an emotional thing?
It's more a cultural thing that at the end we are lucky to be in a private, privately owned company and family owned company. So we look at the long term and we try to do things that we like to do at the end of the day. Of course, we think it's in the benefit of the brand. We think that it has given, as I was saying before, a lot of identity to the brand, and that people and customers recognize it. But it's not, we don't measure it really well. Some stores, it seems that they work a little bit better than the other. Some concepts, we think that they work better than the other, but the reality is that we don't measure it. No.